I'm Robin. I'm a process project engineer at PDV Consultants.
Hi, I'm Emma Flaxon. I work for PM Group as a process engineer.
My name is Nikita Jabli and I work as a process engineer at Shell in India.
At PDV Consultants, we work on process and manufacturing projects in the dairy industry. So I work as part of a team to take in projects from the design phase right through to installation and commissioning.
We mainly work for pharmaceutical clients, so most of my design work is for in the pharmaceutical sector, working on feasibility all the way through to detailed design on a variety of different projects with different clients.
Now, as a process engineer, I support Shell's LNG business, giving me hands-on opportunity to work towards a cleaner world.
What I enjoy most about my current role, I'd say, is that all the different people I get to work with and the fact that no day is the same, every day is completely different. I love having a problem in front of me, not knowing where to start with it at the start, and, you know, getting down and looking at the problem as a whole, talking to more experienced engineers about what their idea might be, bouncing ideas off them, going to the other disciplines, looking at what the impacts to the wider design would be.
The aspect of my current role that I enjoy the most is probably the variety. So in the past 2 years that I've been working at PDV Consultants, I've had the opportunity to do design work, project management, I've worked on timelines, budgeting, I've done site supervision of installations, so I've worked with automation engineers, mechanical engineers, and electrical engineers. And then also I've got the opportunity to do commissioning work, which in my opinion is the most satisfying part of any project because you get to see your process up and running on product.
Working with global teams across international locations has helped me gain enriching experience and develop a global perspective.
In this career, you know, after 2 years, I've only really scraped the surface of what there is to know. I feel like in other jobs, I've got a lot of friends, you know, they're 2 years into their career and they're looking for new opportunities and new challenges. And I just feel with chemical engineering in particular, you could be at the same company or in the same field for years on end and never really get that.
Something I quite often have to remind myself of is that learning is really messy. So you're not going to get from a graduate engineer all the way to a fully fledged experienced engineer without making a few mistakes. And I've made a few mistakes, and that's okay because that's all part of the learning process.
I joined Shell at a time when oil and gas industry was at a dip and recruitments were bleak. But I knew Shell was the right company for me, which resonated with my values. I joined via the assessed internship program, followed by multiple assessments and a long wait till I finally was offered my dream job. I have been working for almost 3 years now, and the role has offered me challenges, but also immense satisfaction.
I'd say one thing is going from that, you know, that uni environment to in the workplace. At university, you get given a problem and it's a bit of a test, really. So you're expected to go away and, you know, think about the problem and do lots of research. And if you can't figure it out, do more research, and you don't get a huge amount of help. Whereas at work, the emphasis is on, you know, getting the job done to a certain level, a certain time frame, and, you know, you're encouraged to go away and think about the problem yourself. But ultimately, if you've got a problem, you can't figure out the answer, then just to ask, and then for next time, you know.
Advice that I would give to students currently looking for a graduate role is to not be afraid to apply for internships rather than graduate positions, because internships are a really good opportunity to give you an idea of what the job's actually going to be like. And it's also an opportunity to make good connections in the industry as well.
I'd say to any graduates looking for a role at the moment, less is more. A lot of people, I think, apply to loads of different companies and different roles and don't really have a look at what the job role actually is. I think it's good to look at your experience and what you might be interested in and trying to find something out there, because ultimately, if you're not really that interested, it will come across in the interview. And, you know, if you actually did get the job, you're probably not going to enjoy the role. LinkedIn is also a really powerful tool. There's so many different job roles out there that I think LinkedIn is probably one of the only places that role is actually advertised. It's about, you know, getting your LinkedIn up to date. It's looking at those roles, maybe even not being afraid to contact people within that business and asking more about the role.
Over the past years, I have realized you don't have to fit a pre-filled mold to succeed. There's a strong culture for support and strong culture to innovate in our industry. There are great opportunities out there for new ideas and dynamic solutions. So I believe we should all have confidence in ourselves and work passionately. As young engineers, we bring immense value to the table.
Be you, back you, and make friends. So by back you, I mean backing your ideas and backing yourself and being confident. So especially as a young woman in the industry, it can be quite hard to back yourself. But yeah, this is still something that I'm working on as well.
You may not be the most experienced in the room, but do express yourself, because new minds and new ideas are always a welcome.
Advice that I would give to students going into interviews is, if you can come across as a type of person that's willing to give anything a go and work hard, I think that does wonders. And also, but also at the end of the day, it's about being yourself. So if you're not the right fit for the job, so say your personality isn't quite the right fit for the team, or you don't have quite enough experience for the job, it's better to be rejected, I think, than be unhappy in a job that you weren't quite the right fit for.
What I would say in the interview is, they're not looking for word perfect answers, something you've learned off by heart to a technical question. They're much more looking for someone that they can work with, and part of that, I guess, is if you don't know the answer to a technical question, it's always good to ask more about the subject, how that works. They're looking for you to problem solve, not relay them off something that you've remembered off by heart.
Be proactive and grab opportunities to build a solid technical foundation. iQumi provides a strong culture for support and a platform to instigate the industry evolution with energy transition, to enable the industry to embrace a learner's mindset and lead with purpose and innovation.
The iQumi have helped me in my career aspirations so far, really from their library of knowledge and the tools they have online. I use the competency framework with my mentor every couple of months to identify those gaps for chartership, and I use that to go back to my manager and align with the project work and what opportunities are out there and how I can really get those gaps filled.
Today, chemical engineering means creating the goods that the public use to live out their everyday lives. So that's water, food, petrol, medicine, for example.
Without chemical engineers, you wouldn't have accessible drugs like paracetamol. You know, those sort of drugs would still be made on a lab scale where it's not cost effective and cost a fortune to the consumer. You know, without chemical engineers, you can't make those drugs on a worldwide scale.
As the world thrives through energy transition, I feel we, as chemical engineers, can bring the best positive impact. One step at a time through small but sturdy steps.